It's been said Lou Rag Sherman is one of the most brilliant baseball minds in Louisiana. The other day, I had the privilege to sit with Mr. Rags and talk about his past accomplishments and his interest in horse racing. Mr. Rags has recently retired from Delgado, where his son Joe has taken over the reins. I asked him about his accomplishments and how long he's been involved in baseball.
42 years. I had 20 years at Loyola University, and I'm on my 20th year when I stepped down and allowed Joe to take over at Delgado. And then for the 40 years, I handled a team that went on to Johnstown, Pennsylvania. We were pretty successful there. We had about 8 championships. Made a lot of good friends. In fact, I was talking with Tommy Lasorda just a couple of days ago, and he made you feel good what he said about you and things like that. So coaching has been good to me, very good.
Like a good horse, Mr. Rags established himself as a winner early, and it's been satisfying ever since.
Well, when I was a young guy, naturally the first team I took to a national tournament, we finished second. The following year we won. That year we won, I can remember the sponsor standing on top of the dugout giving all the equipment away, and I was enjoying it, but I was reminded, hey, tomorrow you got to buy this stuff back.
Some coaches say that kids of today are different than years ago, but Mr. Rags disagrees.
No, I don't believe that. I'll tell you, the only difference I see in coaching is that today you got to tell a kid why. The olden days, you tell a kid, hey, I want you to run through that fence, and you'd hear a big, you know, bump or something when he knocked himself out. But today he's going to ask you, why do you want me to run through that fence, coach? And hey, if you can't tell a kid why, then get out of coaching.
Coach became a fan of horse racing through another popular New Orleans personality, and from there he made selections called Rags to Riches.
It's through Hap Glory. Hap Glory was the sports editor at the Item, or Fred Digby was, I should say, and Hap was very active and covered the races here, and he asked me to make selections. And I thought about it a while, and I said, okay, Hap, I'll make selections, but I'm going to do it a little different. We're not going to try to tell the guy that spent $200 or $300 on horses what horse is going to win. Let's try to reach the general public, the people that comes to the races for the first time. We went on with that kind of a thinking, and I would try to make selections that the people would enjoy.
Through years of experience of handicapping horses, Mr. Rags has put together a few handicapping guidelines.
I'm not going to try to tell your audience out there that I'm a great handicapper. I can tell them I've been successful. I've been successful because I play percentage. I didn't try to pick the winner at the finish line. I felt if I could pick the horse that would be first or even second at the head of the stretch, percentage is going to take care of me down the stretch. You hear around here that, gee, this stretch is too long. But check your charts. Check all your charts, and you'll find out that the horse that's in the first flight, I say first or second, will win 70% of the races. The horse that's leading will win 40% of the races. Then we added a couple of things. I learned from a good friend of mine, John Cucci, who's a pretty good racing handicapper. And he pointed out where a horse that picked up over 5 pounds from his previous race would not repeat. And we checked that out, and we found only 3% of the horses that pick up 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 pounds won't repeat. So, we just used all that together.
Coach admits he's a big fan, but not a big gambler.
I love the races. I love the people. I've always been very interested in people, making friends and things like that. And a lot of them, I can sit by my box. A lot of them like to come and have me mark their program and things like that. I know there's a lot of exaggeration. I heard one guy say, hey, Rags, give me this horse. Yeah, he's betting 400. Rick, I can tell you now, I haven't bet 400 in the whole season.
With the age of OTB and out-of-town simulcasting, Mr. Rags is skeptical about racing's future.
I feel right now is let's don't killer goose that laid the golden egg. And everybody's telling you about off-track betting. I think 25 years ago, you could put on your home television, you may see it in your parlor, and you'll have a machine or a telephone to make a bet to the racetrack. They won't need no racetrack. They'll just need a place to run the races. That's a possibility. But if you have too much of this off-track betting around, we may kill the goose that laid the golden egg. I hope I'm wrong.